Chapter 9. A Call to Ponyville. The next morning, Apple Bloom woke up with the odd feeling that she and the other ponies had been going about this party planning business all wrong. Instead of decorating with tons of twinkly star lights and the moon lanterns, they should make the whole event pitch black. So dark that nobody could see anything at all. Yeah, obviously. It was a wild idea, but Apple Bloom couldn't shake it. The little filly hopped out of bed, ate a quick breakfast of strawberry pancakes with Applejack, and hightailed it over to the Cutie Mark Crusaders clubhouse for an emergency Winter Moon Festival meeting.
"This meeting of the Cutie Mark Crusaders is called to order," Apple Bloom announced, banging her gavel on the podium.
"Can we make it fast?" Sweetie Belle yawned. "I couldn't sleep last night. Something really loud woke me up."
"Was it a big roar-type noise?" said Scootaloo. "'Cause I heard that."
"No, it was Rarity snoring,"
Sweetie Belle chuckled.
"You never expect it, but she really—"
"Come on, girls," Apple Bloom interrupted.
"We have to talk about this festival."
Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo exchanged a look as if to say, "What's wrong with her?"
"Okay."
Apple Bloom unfurled a massive poster and laid it on the ground. A messy hoof-scribbled map of the festival had been drawn on it. She pointed her hoof at the twinkly lights and the lanterns.
"We need to get rid of these and these."
Then she motioned to the gigantic spotlights that were supposed to shine on Princess Luna as she raised the moon.
"And definitely those."
"That's a really strange idea." Scootaloo looked sideways at Apple Bloom. "How are we supposed to see anything without the lights?" Apple Bloom smiled.
"With moon glasses. A pair for every pony in Equestria."
When making any official royal visit, Princess Luna traveled by way of her chariot. The two stallions who pulled it were quite unique. Echo and Nocturne, oh guys, they have a name, were from a race of ponies that lived deep within the mountain caves like bats. They had gray hides, pointed wings, yellow cat-like eyes, and very quiet dispositions. Luna had found them when she'd responded to a call to Smoky Mountain many moons ago, moons after she'd settled the dispute between the bat ponies and the mountain dragons. The princess had arrived to find two bat ponies, separated from their colony and caught within the clutches of an angry dragon who'd left his own tribe because of his endearing resentment toward their species. Luna used her alicorn magic to lull the dragon to sleep, allowing the two stallions to fly away. Deeply grateful for the aid in their escape, Echo and Nocturne offered to serve as her royal guard forever after. "Will you be requiring us on your journey to Ponyville today, Highness?" Echo asked with a bow. He squinted his eyes, which were not used to daylight.
"It shall not be necessary," Luna assured him. It had been a long night, but she was excited to see if her little experiment had worked. "I'm only going for a quick surprise visit." She turned to Nocturne, who couldn't even open his eyes.
"Besides," she chuckled, "you two wouldn't be able to see very well in this daylight."
"Not true,"
Nocturne grunted. He pulled out a pair of shiny sunglasses and put them on. Echo did the same.
"We are prepared for all things, princess."
The princess laughed and took off back toward Ponyville on her own.